Hey there, how you doing? Charlie Winters here with horse racing tips for Friday the 12th of April. Well, first, a quick apology. I've been far too busy to do any videos, look at any form. I don't think I've even had a bet, you know, like, I'll tell you in a second, like the odd pound somewhere, just for a bit of interest. I've had a really poorly chicken. The chicken comes first. It's my little pet or pets. They've been really sick, and I had to spend my time, even off work, ensuring that they're okay. Fingers crossed, fingers crossed they all pull through, but especially one of them, which is really sick. So, what I've done with the form, I'll talk you through it. There's two I'm interested in, and two I've backed recently that clearly look like they've been, that Cheltenham or another race was a prep race, possibly, when I backed it in the past, for possibly Aintree. Let me get into it. So the first selection is Django Bay, or Bay, at 10 to 1 in the 220 at Aintree, paying 7 places instead of 4. This is Nicky Henderson's. It's a really decent quality horse. The run at Kelso last time, similar to another horse that I'm going to mention shortly, I think they sent up to Kelso to get them ready for Aintree for, on say, Aintree is a tight track, but Aintree is, it's a speed favouring track, and you have to be on the front foot, in my opinion. So at Kelso, I personally think that the two horses I'm going to back today, Django Bay being one of them, would have gone to Kelso, and it would have been too sharp for it. And it was just a bit caught out, but still ran a decent race. I think it stepped up very slightly in distance. It's Nicky Henderson, who we need to keep an eye on. I haven't even seen a single race at Aintree's hole. I couldn't tell you how. In fact, I have. Sorry, I didn't see the race. I had a quick flick through the result. I know Sergino won, so I don't know whether it won easily or anything like that. So so I'm going to keep an eye on Nicky Henderson. So that's the first selection. Second selection is Dysart Enos in the 9-2 in the 2:55 at Aintree. There's only 8 runners in this race, so fully expect one to get taken out to knock it down to 2 places. I know Phil O'Brien, I think he said it's the quickest horse that he's ever had. It might be, but is it still quick enough to beat some of William Mullins and Gordon Elliott's? Well, I think it can run a decent race because clearly they've, I can't remember if it was entered for Cheltenham, but it certainly didn't run at Cheltenham. So there are some fancied horses in this race that ran at Cheltenham. Was that to get them, although they still ran well at Cheltenham, is that to get them primed also for Aintree? Was it left a bit short? Or could they possibly be slightly over the top where Cheltenham took a lot out of them? So I've gone for Dysart Enos because I think it's been aimed solely for this race. The third selection is James De Burlo at 8-1 in the 4:05 in the Topham Handicap Chase, paying 7 places instead of 4. This horse was absolutely tanking, in my opinion, when I tipped it at Cheltenham. Once again, it failed to get up the hill. Although it was travelling really well. For horses that can travel really well, Aintree's a spot on course for it. I just don't know if it will jump the fences. It's the Grand National fences. So fingers crossed it does. If it does, if you can tell me that it doesn't fall or doesn't unseat rider and doesn't pull up, I can't kick it out the first 7. And that's not an excuse. That's just my reasoning behind it. And the final selection is Sky Cutter. 9-1 in the 5:15 at Aintree, paying 6 places instead of 4. This horse ran a decent race, although it was similar to the first selection, where it got caught out by a bit by tactical speed because it was travelling well, and I think it might have clipped a hurdle or been shuffled back slightly and could never quite get on terms at Kelso. Even though there's a relative rock, a pretty steep hill, I think once you get shuffled back, it's hard to make it. You really need to get first run and be able to stay on at Kelso. Well, this was shuffled back, it was making ground, and in the end, it was just, I don't think it really lost any ground on the leaders, but he wasn't going to catch them. But he ran a decent race. I think three of these horses recently have been prepped up to run well at Aintree, and I think the second selection, Dysart Enos, has been purposely kept quiet, aiming purposely for this race by keeping it fresh. So the very best of luck. You can give me a like or subscribe. I'd really appreciate it. Charlie Winters, over and out. Cheers, mate.